had these headaches, and I used to sleep a lot and watch a lot of movies. I used to eat a lot. I became like 110 kilograms. I was really fat. And yeah, it was all because of the feeling like nothing is going nowhere. I'm just a guy 20 years old, doesn't have anything to be happy about, doesn't have anything to feel. You just lose the taste of life.
Oh, that's crazy. After the bar mitzvah, we weren't allowed to ride a bike. That means, and from the age from 12 and 12 and a half, you're not allowed to ride a bike. Oh, that's not fun. Oh my God, that's so bad. It's the picture of the first day I'm going to Yeshiva Gdola. Whoa. I tried to smile to the camera. My sister pictured me. The place where I come from, we used to dress like this. You always have to wear a long suit and a hat. It's really heavy. It used to be hot like hell. And for no reasonable explanation. I mean, if a guy wants to change from this suit to a suit without the belt, you're like changing your life. You're a different person now. Like, your parents are gonna be really disappointed and like, well, anyway.
I grew up in Jerusalem.
We're 12, including me. 9 brothers, 3 sisters. My family was very strict.
No wagging. Never happened. It's like touching problems, I don't know. They're just unable to show love, that's it.
No favor. They all suck. In the Torah itself, there's 613 commands. 248 do's and 365 not do.
You're not allowed to do anything unless you're being told.
You don't really choose to become unorthodox, it's just a day when you find out, and it's a long process. I'm in the 21st century and I'm living like 2,000 years ago in a bubble, behind the walls, in a ghetto, and it's just not it. It becomes so hard to be orthodox. I don't want to be orthodox anymore. I see the internet, I see the movies, I see stuff happening, I see the world. And I'm in my little ghetto, in my little hole, trying to figure out how am I gonna go out to this big world.
A little, like 2 months before I became unorthodox, I was in a really bad mental state. I was in a point where I was so depressed and I wanted to kill myself. I mean, you can just imagine which place I was mentally.
I keep running and running and trying to catch you and beg you till death just to love me again. I keep yelling and screaming your name on the streets of my heart and I love you again. Could I just love you again? It's the first song I wrote as an unorthodox guy. It's about my family. It took a year to heal the feelings.
I just came to Jerusalem, and there's a lot of people who know me from the past, and I'm going to my parents, so I'm trying to respect them and feel more comfortable, probably. It feels more comfortable when you look like more similar. So, yeah. What's just a shirt and a yarmulke, so who cares? Respect is always good. So, for the holidays, you have to be at home. I mean, there's no replacement for family, after all. But I'm always telling, don't ask me questions, so I don't need to lie. You don't want to hear, just accept me as I am. I will never tell you exactly what I'm doing in my own life. That's it, she just needs to accept it. Jerusalem kind of makes me nervous. It brings up my old manners, my old behaviors, like which I grew up in. When I'm in Tel Aviv, I feel free because I don't see people like me and I don't see places like I used to grow up, so it's a lot different. And when I'm here, it's kind of, I'm starting to behave like I used to behave in the past. I'm nervous. When if somebody who knows me comes here, wow, I need to explain like an hour now what I'm doing. You have no idea what I mean. The place is crazily beautiful and inspiring. So much history. People died for these things, so I don't know. Confuses you a little bit. I don't believe in believing in God. I don't believe it exists. It's just a psychologically experiment. But it's okay, I just take a little pray and it calms me down. Just charging the battery, the Jewish battery, once in a while. I don't know. Maybe someday I'll start believing again. You can never know. Life is full of surprises, so who knows?
ירוחם?
וואו! מה זה אובר, רואי? סטיב, אני יודע, בגלל שאנחנו הלכנו לסיום סקול. הוא היה בברודרס קלאס.
אנחנו נתנו רק כמה חודשים לפני, כשאנחנו נתנו על אחד אחד שאנחנו נתנו את הקומיוניטי. המילה שלי היה יצחוק, אבל אני לא אוהב את השם הזה, הרבה רגעים. אז אני רק אשנה את זה לשם שאני אוהב יותר.
When he told me first, when I met him, and he told me he changed his name to Steve, and I love the name Steve, and Yitzchak is such an old-fashioned name, like, really. I wanted to change my name, too. Eventually, maybe I won't do it, but when he told me he changed his name to Steve, I was like, wow, nice for you. Yeah, great job, really.
Yeah.
It's cool. I mean, just changing, like, you're changing your past. You're getting out into the real world, where you can choose your name, you can choose the clothes, you can choose the look, you can choose how you walk, how you go, how you jump, how you, whatever you want, you can just choose it.
I did it in, I think, 30 minutes maybe. And 30 minutes was just waiting for in the line. But in the second, I got in, I changed it in 2 minutes.
Wow, I didn't know. Maybe I'll do it too. I mean, if I am getting a new passport, why not? Maybe I'll put in a new name. I want to be called Ben. I love the name Ben. You like it?
Yeah.
Ben Stein. Instead of Chaim Steinberg, I'll just do Ben Stein, and that's it. Cool name, cool American name.
Yeah.
Maybe it will help me to get an American citizenship, which is the dream eventually.
To leave the community, it's not a little thing. It's very, very difficult. It's two different worlds. They're looking at you as not in their community.
You're an outsider. Second, you just look a little bit different. And it's a major step. You just get out and you change all your manners and it's entirely different. It's a different world. You just got reborn.
זה המקום של סבא שלי.
כן. שדוד אותך. אתה
צריך לשבת
למעלה.
כן, נכון. דוד שלי פה. אתה
צריך לשבת פה. וכל אחד שנכנס היה מקבל קבל הספונים רציני.
כן.
ואנחנו היינו עומדים פה זה המקום של השבאבניקים. והיינו מתפללים מפה. Here is the shul, the synagogue where we used to daven, right, as kids. And wow, it brings me up certain feelings I don't want to feel right now. I don't know, it's old and smelly. Feels weird.
Most of the things stays the same.
Yeah. Wow, it's crazy.
Like mixed feelings. One side I'm happy I'm not here. And the other, I'm
a little bit missing.
Something maybe. I'm missing, yeah.
Yeah, it's like the childhood, the happiness, to not know anything, just this place, and that's it. It's incredible. Anyway, wow.
זה נכון, עכשיו אני קולט. אבל לשבת?
מה זה?
אבל לשבת?
מה, אני תדעי את זה? לא, בוא נחתוך מפה, אין לנו יותר מה לעשות פה.
טוב.
לקחתי Yeah, this is my building where I used to live. Wow, this place is funny and nauseous. I don't know. At this place, there's no good memories. It's just bad memories. Heart headaches memories, really. My entire life, even if I win an Oscar, or if I change the world, I'll do the craziest things in the world, and my parents will never be happy with it. They'll never be like, wow, we achieved these goals and anything. No, he did bad things, that's it. I mean, it doesn't matter what will happen. And it kills you from inside. I mean, it's my parents, they're supposed to be happy with everything I do, and they're not even coming to me like an inch. Nothing. They're nothing sacrificing anything for me. So I mean, really, they will never understand me. Doesn't matter what happens. Doesn't matter what happens. I will always be the guy who just disappointed them. The guy who they cry at night because he got an Oscar.
כשאני קיבלתי פטור, הוא אשכרה הביא לי דף. הוא אומר לי, אתה מצאו אותך לא קשיר או משהו כזה, לא הבנתי בדיוק איך הוא אומר את זה, אבל כאילו... אני פשוט לא צריך להתגייס, זה הכל. אבל עכשיו זהו, אני חופשי, אין לי את הפאקינג 3 שנים האלה על הראש, אחי. אני יכול לטוס לאיפה שבא לי, לעשות מה שבא לי, זהו. It's in Hebrew. It has only one line. It says, here I am to inform you that the last recruitment requests is cancelled. Okay, signed by the officer. She's like a serious officer. And I told her, so I can leave the country whenever I want? And she tells me, yeah. So I do it like... she looks at me, what? Seriously? You know, I mean, I'm a serious officer. You're not allowed to do that. But it was fun. I mean, I wouldn't... Yeah, I was really crazy. I felt like, wow, really happy. I didn't expect it. I mean, half a year you're in the process, and then a month before you're getting recruited, like the final interview, and then they tell you you're not qualified, or whatever they called it. I mean, it was a little insult. I mean, why do you call it I'm not qualified? I am qualified to serve. So now I'm like stuck without anything, and without a job, and without an apartment in 2 weeks. But for now, I feel like, wow, I can go check out the entire world. A lot of Israeli guys will be very angry because they served and I'm not serving, but believe me, I've been through a lot. I mean, I don't own this country anything, so I'm kind of not feeling guilty. Just go to another place, speak a different language, start feeling, you know, just a little opening myself to stuff. Anyway, I'm going to leave the country, so who cares?
Purim party!
Yeah! It's like the Jewish Halloween, but less fun.
How do you speak English so well?
Wow. It's kind of hard for ex-Haredi to go to a regular club and get connected. When I go to a regular club, I barely dance, and here I just junk myself out.
שלום.
מה
העניינים? אני טוב.
אפשר לעבור?
מה קורה? I'm going to Hillel, because this is a place where Ex-Haredim meet. You can actually eat Shabbat dinner, feel like at home, but you can smoke a cigarette and play with your phone and do whatever you want, so it's different. It gets really crowded and it feels like really warm and huggy. It's a lot easier. It's people just around you and everybody's like you. It's not coming to a place and everybody talks about high school and you don't even know what high school means.
I was forced to change, you know. There was never a moment I decided to do something, except the moment we talked about, you know, when I decided I'm leaving the yeshiva, I'm calling Hillel. But everything I did is because I was forced to change, because I suffered so much in the yeshiva. It was boring. It took me so many years to leave because I was afraid. I was afraid to admit to myself, this is not the place for me. I knew nothing else. So
yeah, that's true.
I called Hillel.
Oh, that's incredible.
And from then they took me, you know, they showed me the way.
What are you working?
I'm studying mechanical engineering, and I'm working at computer. Well, everything
oh, nice.
Else I can put my
like
hands on, I love
set.
To fix things.
You have a set life.
No, not at all.
More than mine, believe me.
Yeah, but I think I was in the same situation when you is now, like 3 years ago.
Yeah, everyone has to start somewhere.
But I wanted to go to the army, but they didn't accept
me. They rejected
me.
You?
Yeah.
Like me?
Like, I was too old for them. And you, the same reason?
No, I don't know if it's the same reason, but they rejected me. And thank you. I mean, thank God, thank anyone
oh,
who's...
Oh, really? I wanted to go to the army so much.
When I had to go, I wanted to go too, but you know, when you get the free path, you're just happy it didn't happen. I don't want to get out of the army when I'm 25 and, you know, with no life and anything.
Oh, really? But I think that when you leave the army, that sometimes you have a whole career before they give you, I don't know,
not really,
you can study for free and...
Not for me, they didn't offer me anything. I don't know, you need to fight for everything you want, you need to fight for it. Like it's, I don't know, maybe I'll get some job, just save some money. I want to go to the United States, probably.
What, to live there?
I want to live there, but it's not really possible. So first of all, I want to be there. I want to see Manhattan, I want to see LA. Yeah.
I spent 3 years in the US. I'm a citizen, American citizen.
Shut up.
Yeah.
So you can work at whatever you want.
Yeah.
Why did you need
and
to work at
I
this?
Didn't. I didn't know new English. My parents didn't speak English, but my father is American.
I hate people who have an American citizenship.
I know.
I hate them so much, you have no idea.
Cost $10,000, you know?
No, it's not just the money. It's seriously, just have such a privilege. If I had an American citizenship, I wouldn't be here another day.
הנושא יעסוק בדרך לקבלת החלטות נכונות. אנחנו רואים את עצמנו במראה, ואנחנו בכלל שואלים את השאלה האם אני מוצא, האם אני עצמי מוצא חן בעיני עצמי או לא. מה הרחוב יגיד על ההופעה שלי? הוא כן אוהב את זה או לא אוהב את זה? שהרחוב כן יאהב או לא יאהב, ישנה רצח את ההופעה שלך, זה לא מעניין אותו. אתה לבוש, יאללה.
הגיעו מלא דברים חדשים.
People don't need clothes for guys like me who don't really have the money to buy new clothes and I need a new collection. So, you see, I'm just trying a few stuff. I like colors. I like to be dressed nice, not that I have a big chance at it. Maybe if I had more money and I had like a place to choose, but I don't know. I have my clothes now in my apartment, it's from here. It's gonna be small? Nah. Wow. I lost 30 pounds, kilograms.
Really?
Yeah, I used to be like 110 because I wanted to fit in all shirts. Possibly. See, now I fit in this shirt.
You have a strong will.
Yeah, sure. Wall power.
תראה
לי איך זה יושב. נחמד. תעמוד וכזה, תסגור,
זה לא
זוכר
ככה,
תסגור
את זה. וגם
מכנס. מה,
להכניס
פנימה? כן, המכנס לא קשור פה בשביל.
לא,
אחר,
דווקא פנימה.
There's no bureau or department in the government who helps for ex-Haredim. There's articles in the paper for now and then, you know, about people like me. But the government doesn't really do anything. They just ignore the entire situation. Mostly because they don't even know what it means, and I think it's also because that the Orthodox people in the government really work hard. The government won't support anyone who does the same step as I did. And they have really a lot of power in the government. So it's really sad because there's no help from the government. I mean, I grew up 20 years with no education, no basic conditions a kid needs to have. And even though the government ignores it like it doesn't exist. I have the education of a boy in the fourth grade, something like that. We studied just the basic stuff, reading and writing, and basic math. There's no sport, just sitting all day and studying. Torah all the time. When you come out to the regular world, you just know a lot of stuff in the Torah, but it doesn't really help you. I mean, eventually I need to make a bagriot. Most of my education I catched up from movies, watching movies and seeing stuff and then check it up on the internet what it means. Somebody says Albert Einstein, somebody says Leonardo da Vinci, somebody says Mozart. You just check up who is Mozart and then you find out. So the internet, yeah, it saved a lot of lives. Socialism and capitalism, I mean, I think it's mostly the same, no? If I understood it right. Capitalism is like a... Wow, I don't really know how to... What's the difference in these two? I mean, I do know the basic things, but... Okay, I need to check it. You see, now you brought up something. I need to check capitalism and socialism. Yeah.
אתה מגיע לאזור הסופרלנד בקרוב?
סופרלנד?
כן?
קרוב,
אוקיי. אז את באה ממש מ-strict family, כאילו.
ממש חרדים, כן.
וואו, אז את מלאה בקאס לא פחות ממני, אה?
ברור.
זה לא נראה עליי.
היום אני כבר, כאילו...
כמה שנים אמרת?
אני גם עזבתי את הבית בגיל 14, אז כל הכעס שלי נתן לי גם את האומץ לעזור. אבל עם הזמן אני פשוט יותר...
צעיר כל כך. וואו, גיל 14, כאילו.
כן, זה היה מטורף.
מה עשית, כאילו, שעזבת הבית?
וואי, זה עושה סיפור. בהתחלה פשוט קמתי ויצאתי ממש לרחוב. ומשם סיפור, אבל... אבל צריך לעשות דברים כיפים, כמו זה נגיד. תחשוב לצאת למקומות, תחשוב על דברים שעשו. טוב, בחיים לא ראיתי אותך ככה שמחה, באמת, איזה כיף זה.
וואי, לגמרי, חוויה.
כן. נו לפעל.
When you grow up until you're 21 and you've never been in an amusement park, your entire life you're just dreaming to do this thing. When you become old, it's like funny. You're an old guy. So I just do it. I mean, the world can kiss me. first I didn't really know how to behave. It just happens with the time. It's like you come to a different country and you don't know the language. At some point it takes like a year or a year and a half and then you just get the language. That's how it works. So you're not a regular guy. You just face it. I mean, even now, you're in almost a year and a half after that, I'm still not a regular guy. Everything was new. I mean, there wasn't anything I used to know. I went to the beach. I saw like women with bikinis the first time in my life. At first, it was really hard. I used to talk to girls. I used to like my eyes instantly used to go down. Like it was really hard to look at a girl in her eyes and talk to her. When I used to go to the bank or to a doctor, and he had this secretary, let's say, and I need to talk to her, so you just look down, because you're used to it. Like, that's how you've been taught, not to look to women. For me, looking at a woman is like for a normal guy looking at a naked woman.
I've never been in love. I don't know, I think being in love is like having a God. Oh, I believe in God. You just create him in your mind and then you say like he exists. Right now, if I would have a girlfriend, I would ruin your life. I mean, it's so not in a place where I can have a girlfriend. Like, no, I'm not there. Everything needs to be planned, and even though it's not so much fun for a young guy like me, I mean, usually you just want to run away and that's it. And if I just run now, I mean, my chances to end up a cab driver in New York are really good, but I don't want to be a cab driver. That's something I catched up from my sister. Every time somebody's coming to visit, she doesn't have time to change the sheets. She puts a little laundry softener, and with a little water. We just spread it on all the clothes and the sheets. Man, I just have one set of sheets. I don't really have to change, so for me it's like necessarily. Guys are coming to see the room because I'm renting it. So they're coming to see how it looks like. I mean, yeah, they want to check the place. Maybe they want to rent it. I use it too for girls, but that's a secret.
אתה רוצה לראות עם הידיים? כן, אתה רוצה לראות עם הידיים? 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 אתה רוצה לראות עם הידיים?
We grew up together. Two, like, best friends, yeah. It's the guys I hang out a lot, and we have a lot of what to talk, so I like these guys. And they're open-minded. I mean, they like to be Orthodox, and they like where they are, and they don't want to leave, and they want to be... I mean, they study Torah and everything, but they didn't, like, cancel me from their life because I chose differently.
לא, לא היה לי שום... אף פעם לא ניסיתי להגיד לו ששייך, יצא לי להחזיר אותו לדעת, ממש לא. לא זה עבדתי.
יש לו יותר חיים עכשיו. זאת אומרת, עם בעיקר מה שהיה עם כל הדברים האלה, כל הפאות והזקן וכל הזה, שם אז לא היה לו חיים. זאת אומרת, הוא היה ב... לא היה עם חיים בכלל. עכשיו יש לו לייף, כמו שאומרים.
He has like a sentence. He always said, a breeder is a breeder. את זה היא מבינה, היא מבינה...
אה, יידיש. קודם כל, דבר ראשון שחיים מתחתן.
אחרי זה... בחורה צדיקה.
בחורה
סמינר טובה.
צדיקה יפה וחסודה. אחרי זה אנחנו, בעזרת.
שנותנת פעם בשנה.
לא, חס וחלילה.
אז צריך להבין, הם באים ממגזרים שונים לגמרי משלי. כאילו, אני אין לי חברים במגזר שאני בא ממנו.
אגב, הוא היה כבר מות נשוי היום. בגיל 18 הם מתחתנים.
בבית שלי
זה לצ'למרס, כאילו, הם מתחתנים בגיל, זה לחסידים, זה היה גילאים.
אני כמעט התחתן, אפילו היה, אתה זוכר בבחורה היא, שהיינו... It was like this close, and it was really close to the park where I left my family. It's just... They felt like I'm going to do some stupid stuff, so yeah, like they wanted to end it like really fast, because that's the solution for everything. I mean, whenever there's a problem with a guy in the Orthodox community, so let's get him married, let's get him married, and you know, just get him with some girl and a lot of pressure, and it's like a main brain prison. Like, you don't really have a choice. Like, they're asking you yes or not, but eventually you have to answer yes, and there's already the cakes and the drinks in the freeze, in the refrigerator when you're meeting the girl. It's like, it's already set. But eventually I got saved.
תבוא, תצטרף איתנו. יש לך פה מיטה חינם. לא, אבל חיים, אתה צריך פה עבודה קבועה עכשיו, כאן? נסדר משהו.
גדול.
השם טוב, הוא טוב במחירות, כאילו, למחירות.
בטח.
אני אהיה טוב.
יאללה, זזנו?
I'm packing. I'm packing, I'm moving out. I would have given everything to stay here. I'm just moving into my friend Hesky's house. And there I don't need to pay rent. Nepark is just my last option for now. It's an Orthodox city, it's like the main Orthodox city. It's really strict, you know, you can't do anything on the streets, that's for sure. I'll just get a temporary job and try to make as much money as I can without paying rent, which is the most important part. And afterwards, just take a trip for a few months, and then come back, start studying, getting a degree, and be like every normal guy. I guess that's normal, right? That's it, that's my room. There's the bed, it's really small. Yeah, It's still not organized. You need to organize it. Whew. I'm starting to realize I'm still young. Because where I come from, when you're in my age, you already have two kids. I don't need to conquer the world in one day, so no pressure for now. I've never been outside the country, so when I come to a place like this, it makes me doubt, because after all, Israel is so great. But I don't know, as long as I haven't seen Manhattan, it's kind of not fair to ask me. But Israel has what to offer, yeah, I guess so. I can see the finish line of me being a regular guy, the end of the tunnel. I used to be afraid of people, afraid of liking people, afraid of people liking me, like taking things, taking help from people. Maybe I still need to act a lot, but it's a lot easier to act when you're almost halfway there. God bless me. Yeah, I guess.